Well, I suppose. So, have you gotten some decent Terrans in here at least? That is not very aggressive. Blue is barcode, might be ink, and Campbell is already staying in base. Alright, let's try to get an in-base Terran. Let's see how that works. So, one guy already left. Oh wait, didn't even connect. That's great. Yeah, time for experimentation. So he's already walling in. And I'm curious to see how that goes. Quite curious. So it's actually 1.2 seconds, so that is, oh god, 20%. Might have to upgrade. No, that's not the upgrade I'm looking for. Wait, what's like the fifth? That's like 10 damage per second. Something along those lines. So you do in fact need more than one SCV to deal with this. Which is a thing. And quite a few more, as a matter of fact. Like at this point, I'm just probably gonna send these over here because they're not gonna do anything there. And just go full tanklings. And I think we're in. Okay, he's actually still somewhat tanking this. Well, I wonder what happens once we get armor. So, let's try those guys. One mid. I mean, it's actually a bit overtuned, I think. That damage is a bit too serious. From my first impression. All right, well, let's send these over. Looks like we're not gonna break a total turn with that little effort. Quite anyways. It basically to deal 10 damage versus walls. Like only 3 damage versus SCVs, which is hilarious. Alright, do we get early armor? I mean, might as well, right? And the problem is you actually need to micro them now because they stand at me, or attack wars. So you can't go pure tanklings, they will just kind of not do anything. Let's just go for his buildings, honestly. Don't think what's wrong with that. Upgrade this guy. This is so random. This is so random. Yeah, that's actually not enough. We will eventually break through this. Oh boy. Oops. So, but it does only spawn 3, so it's not as bad. Well, let's also grab some infestors with this. So from what I can tell is that it definitely buffs Zerg quite substantially. To the point where any amount of Loop Terrans, basically it's the whatchamacallit, Zerg Square problem. Because I'd imagine if I just do this now, he's gonna be in very serious trouble. Same with Smith last game. Yep, that's pretty much the way this game goes now. Let's just go down there, gotcha. So, I think we're making progress. Why are you going over there? No, 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 just go down here. Oh, now he's moving out, okay. That complicates things a bit. He is trying his heart. Alright, his eco is still terrible. Not that it matters. Actually... how much does this cost? 250. Good morning. Actually, let's place this behind the big spine, or somewhat close to it anyways. So, let's let this walk around. We may actually need units against this guy. May. So, I think at this point you pretty much stop doing mass tanklings. Sitting like, oh boy, I don't even wanna. So, this thing has armor and does 10 damage. Okay. Is there another one spawning? There's another one spawning. Okay. We have two of these now. They are pretty slow though. Let's see. And they just kind of die. Okay. Well, we figured that out. Turns out those guys are still trash. Let's test their wall slaying abilities. I mean, the plus one armor alone actually should make them relatively decent against creepers. Reapers, I mean. Yeah, this guy seems to like his walls, which is slightly on the issue side of things. So he's gonna build a yard here. Okay, let's see the wall impact in action. I mean, it does definitely do AoE. You can tell that much. So my ally bought another supply. Clawing our way up the eco train or eco ladder. I mean, beastlings are still pretty terrible. I think there's a maximum of 2, alright, per spawner. Let's just see what beastlings do. Kinda wish they were a bit faster. But basically what this patch did is you can now definitely push any Terran back and just straight up kind of kill them. So definitely buff the early aggression of Zerg. With the effect that if said Terran doesn't have decent teammates, the game is pretty much over. So in any random lobby, Zerg is gonna be much more powerful now. This is the first impression anyways. Yeah, luckily Reaper damage costs like 350 initial gas, so that's not that easily achieved. Let's just have these like come around here, I'd say. Okay. Oh, turrets. Nice. Yeah, this guy's gonna be non-issue. So, like, even that setup can't hold the basic beastling, or, like, tankling damage. As you can see, we can just kind of probably kill this wall right here. No, actually, not really, but it's taking damage, so if he doesn't have units there, it's gonna be toast. Alright, let's build a bunch more spawners. Alright, he's also building turrets now. And it's pretty much the gist of this patch here. Which has its pros and cons. But I'd say definitely for most lobbies that's definitely a con. Well, pretty much what you do is you build a bunch of tanklings on a guy, make sure he doesn't get his walls up, and then you can go for like 6 to 8 minute armor one, and then just get a couple of infestors and then just finish him off. Yeah, I mean, before you could actually like kind of hold the Zerg focus. You don't anymore. How did this guy take damage? I guess creepers. And we're killing walls. Looks like two defenders might be almost be enough. Oh boy. Oh boy. What have you done? What are Red's units doing down here? Like, why? The only explanation is that there are some side gases. Actually, we should check with tanklings, they deal way more damage now. I mean, armor reward doesn't... Huh. Don't think they actually make it there. This is the most random setup ever. Okay, well, looks like we're facing turrets. I mean, turrets should work quite well against beast tanklings, actually. Probably. After all, slowlings are much better equipped. Yeah, I mean, I don't think there's gonna be any serious pushes this game, to be honest. That doesn't seem like on the Terran's agenda. Alright, we should definitely mix up the equal to spawner ratio. Like, this is the most serious push we can expect here. And I think even he's just dying to spines, it would seem. So, yeah. Early Banes. Did Banes get buffed? I mean, armor 2 for that. Let's try Banes. Okay. This is still kind of expensive though. Alright, where would one place these? Ah, let's just place them. Actually, not that in base, let's place them here. We require more minerals. Let's not tell anyone that we could have had Brutus by now. Almost. To be honest, like, Banings probably don't even kill this guy. Yeah, why build Vikings these days? Did he at least get the banklings? He did. Nice. Yeah, no, we need more eco for banelings, honestly. But each painting basically costs like 2,000 minerals at this point. I'm not sure if it's worth it. Mutation complete. Not really, right? And they also just kind of die to units. I think they have like 190 HP, right? They aren't even. Like, oh god. Like, even this side could probably kill like 2 banelings before they hit. Well, yeah, that's the idea eventually. But we probably need like 10 banelings in order to actually just make it to the command center. I should probably just fuse this spine, honestly. Also, get a couple more infestors in between. We require more minerals. So, so I'm assuming Red is done with his. I'm gonna walk around the map stuff, right? So I can just kind of put nests here now. That's quite a gamble. Honestly, I don't even have things to deal with this. Okay. Well, looks like. Okay, I guess we make some roaches. Those are actually vets with. Out combat shields. Is he gonna go further than that? He wouldn't, right? Nah, surely not. Okay, well. More slowlings it is. Actually, we can make striklings, right? Way more cost efficient. It may have just helped our eco quite a bit, significantly. So, meat shield for the banelings. Which is it shall be. So, am I maxed out on banelings? Nope, one more. We may also need some attack upgrades, actually. How much damage should we do? 60. Yeah, that's not enough. Let's just do that. How much do they do now? Oh, 17. So we don't have unified armor yet. Oh, Firebats for defense. Nice. Quickly, kill him! Oh! Okay, well, we did not kill him. Oh, no, let's not quite lose infestors here. He's actually pushing, which is. Gotta be honest, mildly scary. And with an amount of units, that is potentially somewhat dangerous. Well, let's get some of these OP guys. Oops. So, this should not make it home. Oh boy. May have trolled too long. Potential. That is, of course. Honestly, I feel like Bannings would just crush this guy. Probably need way more infestors here. That is correct. Does he have any ward upgrades? He's gotta have like 5 buggers. Oh no, wait, he probably mostly died. So, he did repair his wards and he got a ward upgrade, okay. Let's hope they make it. Well, we are in anyways. We are in. So that's a plus. It looks like he's using energy on roaches. Not the best idea. To do like 4 damage. Is this scary enough? I'd say it actually is. Let's use these bannings a bit more wisely though. Let's see. Actually there's not much wiseness to use here. So bottom line, we didn't kill him yet. An issue. Oh. Some micro potential. We killed an SCB in 2 walls. And that is a yard of some sorts in the front, probably there. Oh, and an Eternus. Yeah, I've been building bandings and he's been building eco. That's how that came to be. Oh, and a turret push. Okay, it looks like it probably should stack up. Eight bandings seems about right. Nah, this game is like still far from over. There is a decent chance that we still somehow lose this. I mean, all the turns we need to do is just move out, basically. Or not move out, just iron, actually. All the things. Oh, he has elites. Would you look at that. Would you look at that? The impressive thing is he's been doing this all of one gas. Do Hydras really counter turret push? I don't know. I mean, they would, yeah. That might also counter turret push though. Definitely. So, I mean, Tanklings have now 3 armor, which is more than a Roach. Do you actually also have more HP than a Roach? No, they had like 50 HP. Do I still have a Tankling? I don't. He does though. Of shenanigans we can do down here.
The Hive cluster is under attack.
I do all the units now, just noise. I like. I don't think Tanklings are better than Roaches in the long run. Don't think they are. I'm quite convinced Roaches is probably still better. I mean, Tanklings have... No wait, they only have 2 armor, right? At armor 3. But not 3 armor. We should check. Yeah. So, no, definitely not greater than Roaches. Yeah, Tower Roach is also a thing. Oh, he got himself another bugger. Jesus. All the buggers in the world. So do we upgrade these as well? I guess. According to some research, Tanklings are still better than... actually, Roaches are still better than anything late game. So let's make sure we donate another few Bargos if he ever wants to have some. Bit of wall busting. Good. I mean, do they really overkill now? Like, they deal 11 damage, right? 12. And what does one of these Tower Witches have? Like 40. I mean, it's basically 8 overkill, yeah. So. Come on. What do we have Banelings for? I mean, probably not needed, actually. How many walls does he have? 4. It's quite a few. That is quite a few. This is Roaches. We have a few attack upgrades. Make sure we attack the left wall. Well, somebody right where I actually got damaged. Six more upgrades now. Oh boy. He did not share control. How rude. Oh, this guy's clearing nests. Alright, well, let's get a brooder of some sorts. Get one of those. I think then we should be fine, right? Yeah. I mean, he's actively rebuilding his walls for other things. Looks like he's at a stage where we don't even damage it anymore, or kill it rather. Where are those coming from? Okay, let's get some more eco going. We require more minerals. So where do we still need creep? Right there. Let's go up to Hydras, and I think with Hydras we should crush this guy, probably. Ah, that's the idea eventually. If this guy attacked smartly like that, yeah, he might actually just make it. Also, I feel like it's a few too many brooders, actually. That much is clear, sir. Kinda is definitely the word of choice here. It's okay, I've seen worse. And I made a Zork guide today. Actually, not like a couple days ago. That works, yeah. True, those exist. I should make some of those. Maybe. Nah, he's actually still killing all these units with his energy, so I'm gonna keep my roaches. Yeah, do I give him control? Let's try. Oh, we're being scanned. We are being scanned. Did some damage. I mean, nobody really could have imagined that tanklings would be that broken, like... Right now I would just say mass tanklings on one guy. Got a couple infestors and then try to break the others. I have this full array of... I don't even... So, where are his relics? We can't see. But he did send some forages to the bottom. Nice. I don't think there's gonna be any irons ever. Those don't look to be the Terrans to do so. Nah, never mind. That is top. Okay. Top actually somewhat decent. I mean, bottom also got an Invitalis. But he got like tier 3 on one gas, which is, I don't know how you would do that. Or why. So definitely looks like we need to kill top first, but top has kind of way too much going on. Oh, sucks to be him. Orange did leave his base. He actually cleared my entire low ground. And I don't think he actually has 6 buggers. Shell control he did, yes. Didn't quite do it. And I think he somehow killed most of his marines, right? Okay. We're a bit late. Ever so slightly. It's okay. Just get in there. Kill the tanks. Kill the Italians. Or not. So maybe we can save some of these guys. Alright. Mutation complete. Yep. Wait, where did my cloud go? Oh god. It's like not even. Yeah. I may have messed up my cloud a bit. Okay, well. time to bring out the big guns. Honestly, just an Omega at this point. So, I mean, he did have a tank before. I don't think he cared too much, honestly. So, luckily he does not seem to know what these things are.
We require okay. More minerals.
So, does he have infestors close by? He does.
The hive cluster is under attack.
This looks like a tank shot of sorts. So I wonder if we can't... So, I mean, nobody watched the eco-balance. Okay. So, we got his infestors for transfuse purposes, that's great. I mean, he should slowly fall right now. He's got another. He's got another.
The hive cluster is under attack.
Let's see if that hinted somewhere. Bane's after Taurus, I mean, sure. Not like... Hmm. I guess we don't care about Ecos. Perhaps I may have needed that money to do stuff. I guess we wait a couple of seconds. I guess we do wait a couple of seconds. So, yeah, I'm not gonna be the one that does stuff here. So, what is bottom up to? Sure, let's go bot in the meantime. So, well, I'd say that worked. So, okay, well, round two. I feel like all our units are going there slowly. No, 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 don't quite send them in yet. That's not how it works. I mean, he actually only has vets. Okay, maybe do send them in. The Omega, of course, only being the scare factor. Alright. Well. That was way too awkward.